You just don't know what you have till it's gone. When I graduated from high school, I could not wait to get out of Tupper Lake and as far away as I could. I attended college in Western New York. It was flat, windy, no place to swim, no place just to get away. Now, I had been brought up with a love of nature. We went hunting, fishing, camping, skiing, you name it. I took it for granted. At college, I realized not everybody shared my experiences. Each time I came back on school breaks, I'd pass that sign in Welcome to the Adirondacks, and I began to realize just what I'd left. So I decided to take a job in Tupper for a while, see what would develop. Next thing I knew, 10 years had gone by. But by then, I had bought a house on the Racka River and settled in. At the start of the Weill Center Maple Project, I had no interest in the production of syrup, just the finished product. After all, I enjoyed maple on snow as a young child and visited a local sugar shack with my dad, but I gave it very little thought. That is until a friend of mine at the Weill Center brought local syrup into our hunting camp. He also brought a cranberry compote made with maple syrup from fresh, locally picked cranberries, and I was hooked. He even got me to pick cranberries, a first. I brought them home and my wife said, "More please." The next step was maple syrup. The Weill Center Maple Program wanted more participants. No matter how much sap you brought in, you would at least leave with one pint of syrup. It was a sweet deal. Just one problem, I only had one maple tree. Ooh, not to worry, my neighbor also had one. So there I was with my one quart of sap, while the guy behind me had five-gallon pails. I just told him that my quart would top off the 100-gallon tank. Every drop counts. Because you just don't know what you've got till it's gone.